Welcome back, geology fans. This will probably be the most quickly outdated episode of Earth Explorations, and I can't predict what will be coming and going in the years ahead, so if you're listening to this a decade or so in the future, then go ahead and check and see if these apps still exist, but search to see if something better is out there in the future now. I want to start with some of the drone apps, and I'm only giving an overview of these uses, by the way. The first app is called Hover, and it is the first app I open before flying. It lets me know weather conditions and even solar flare conditions, which can affect your radio signals, but most importantly, it lets me know if I can legally fly where I am. I know national parks are off-limit, but I don't know where every airport is and the strange government facilities or whatever. Sometimes you can fly near a stadium when there's no game, but are restricted during games. This app updates to let you know if you are restricted, what restriction, and who to contact if you wish to pursue getting permission to fly in an otherwise restricted zone. So that's how I use Hover. Drone Deploy is the app I use for mapping, but they require a membership to do the extensive work on their internet site. Costs some money, so this geologist is now looking into how to stitch photos with Pix 4D. Not ready to give a tutorial on that yet because I don't know how, but I will probably still use the Drone Deploy app to fly the missions as it's easy to set your flight path and monitor your battery use, and it easily files the photos with capping move files for ease of pulling out multiple missions on a card. So Drone Deploy for taking a series of pictures in a systematic overlapping pattern for mapping. Litchi has many uses, but I use it to capture 360 images. Launch the drone to the desired height, max 400 feet or 120 meters in the United States, and set the panorama functions with this button, and start. And the program and drone work together to take the picture series, which I then have to take into this freeware program, Hugin, I think that's how you say that, and export that work to Photoshop and make it an accessible image, which so far I can only place on Google Street View, Oculus Rift, and Facebook, but I hope that will change soon. And it can't take pictures of the sky, so it's 360 with no ceiling. I know there are some drones out there that look up now, but you're going to be looking at blades. There are other videos out there on this Litchi 360 workflow. This is just an overview here, so go look for those videos if you're interested in that workflow. I am currently happily using the DJI Mavic, and so use the DJI app to do most basic flying and video photo work, especially the more artistic shots, but keep an eye on what's out there for whatever you're flying. Next come the on-the-ground apps, with the most important for the beginning basic geologist, Rocked, or Rocked, I think it's Rocked. This app will allow you to immediately know what rock formation is below your feet, its basic stats, and see the recorded geologic map for the area. It gives you a compass, which quickly records strike and dip when you place your phone against a surface, and this is where it is important to keep a phone case with a flat back. You have to lay the back of your phone on the surface so you can read or tap to freeze and read the data on the screen, and you don't want to be scratching up your screen placing that against the rocks, so your case back needs to be flat. With this button, we see Ron Blakey's paleogeographic map for the time, so I assume this app function works a little bit better for the Western United States, but please let us know how these apps work in other parts of the world in the comments below. There is a check-in function in Rocked, which appears to work globally and allows you to add rock descriptions to locations around the world through this Rocked app. And lastly, a list of minerals known in the area, and I doubt it's complete. You can join geologic communities through this app to share data. Overall, a good first app to download for the beginning or professional geologist. The next one that is good for beginner and professional alike is Peakfinder AR. And yes, there is a small cost for some of these apps, but if I'm mentioning the app, I'm definitely saying it's worth it. This one lets you know what those topographic features around you, whether they be hills or mountains, are called, and their peak heights, and also tells you where east and west are, and what time sunrise and sunset is, where the sun will be in the sky. And this can really help triangulation to locate your position. It does give you your position, including elevation at the base, and you can even raise up to get perspective. Very useful. Then again, it has what I call the severe drunk functions, such as button for the date, time, and visibility. I guess you can adjust the time to see what angle the sun will be in the sky. Peakfinder AR is also obviously a good app for both beginner and professional. But here is an app that is useful for beginners and very useful for professionals. FIELDMOVE Clino has been quite the rage in my department the last few years. First off, it is a compass that can be set and read to read trend and plunge or strike and dip with an automatic right-hand rule. Again, you need a flat back phone case, which you can then place against the surface you wish to measure. Make sure your location services are on, tap the bar to record, and then you can tell the program which formation you are in. You have to code in these formations beforehand and can assign any color you want. It's your own little strat column there on your phone. You can also indicate if you are measuring a bedding surface, a fault, a joint, or whatever with the ability to assign other designations. The appropriate symbol is then placed on a map for you in the proper location and orientation, color-coded for the formation it is in, and you can pull up and edit data on each recorded symbol. Are you convinced this program is worth your while yet? But wait, there's more. With this program, you also get the ability to take a picture, take notes on that picture, have it record where you took it and the direction you were facing, and place a symbol on the map for easy access. You can create multiple projects and have the stratigraphic order of the rock formations and their names stored on your phone and color-coded, ready to go for all your various areas. And then there's this STEREONET function. The program automatically plots your data on a stereo net, which is a 3D representation of the position of all the structures in your area. The patterns that come out can tell you something about deformation patterns, geometric relationships. It'll be the focus in our next episode. Just know for now that it's great to be able to plot this automatically. And all this data you collected in FIELDMOVE Clino can be exported to be worked on in other programs, such as this last one called STEREONET, which, like FIELDMOVE Clino, can plot your data for you on a STEREONET, but has a bit more functionality for the professional. But it's hard to describe how useful without first covering STEREONET construction and use. But that is a good starting list of apps you might find useful, but please keep in mind your smartphone is not always in tower coverage when in the field, that the GPS locator and compass on your phone are not perfect and can even come out of calibration. Turning on and turning off location services occasionally will help reduce location error and pull that good old-fashioned Brunton or Silva compass out occasionally to make sure all is right from time to time. Using the apps, like FIELDMOVE Clino, it is a lot easier to quickly jump from place to place taking rapid measurements with your phone than pulling out the compass each time and locating yourself on the map and placing the correct symbol in the correct direction. But this will need to be done eventually. So occasionally transcribe your FIELDMOVE Clino map to your base map. Digital is awesome, but analog is still invaluable. This was by no means a comprehensive overview of apps you might use. I use Google Slides because sometimes I want images available to me out in the field and I like to be able to share them easily. Nor was this a comprehensive overview of how to use all the apps mentioned here. I hope you will explore using these apps, and I'd love to hear in the comments how you use these apps or any other apps in your personal adventures. But it seems we need to cover those stereo nets. So we will spend some time with these web-like graphs when we crawl back next time, here on Earth Explorations.